So let's try to solve down this first problem. You know, so this problem is a similar problem sa ano ba, CE Board November 2013. So check natin. Yeah. So a concrete beam daw, which is 350 mm wide by 450 mm depth, deep, is simply supported on a span of 5 meters. Again, gaya ng sabi ko sa inyo, ang mga beam sa board exam is it's either simply supported or yung mga common types of beams, which is napakadali, no? So the beam is reinforced with 4 28 mm bars in tension and 2 28 mm bars in compression. Again, meron tayong 4 sa tension, meron tayong 2 sa compression. So we are given with the properties of concrete, 20.7 FY415. Concrete cover to centroid of reinforcement is 17. Take note, importante to kasi minsan sa board exam, ang concrete cover kasi na binibigay is clear cover. I think na-explain ko na last time ang kaiba ng clear cover sa concrete. I mean, clear cover sa centroid cover, di ba? Anyway, dito, we are given with a centroidal cover. So, balance steel ratio is 0.021. Isang hint ninyo, or isang parang hint ba na ang gagamiting raw max is 0.75 raw balance is the fact na ibibigay ng examiner ang raw balance. Okay? Again, although hindi sinabi dito na raw max is 0.75 raw balance, okay, so usually, no, ang ibig sabihin no, na ang gagamitin niya is 0.75 raw balance. However, we can still check, no, using our raw max na gagamitin. Anyway, sinabi kasi dito na 0.9 yung reduction factor. So, gagamitin natin na raw max is yung pinakita ko sa inyo, which is, yeah, yung 3 over 8. Okay, so let's try to solve. First, i-declare ko muna yung mga, ilagay naman natin yung given dito, ha? Kasi ganito yan. So, yung given natin, we have the beam width, 350 mm, ang height is 400, ang span is 5 meters, apat, no? Na 4 28 mm diameter bar. So, ilagay na lang natin agad AS. Total AS is 4 times 28 square, di ba? Or 4 times pi over 4, tama ba? Circle ba? Area ng circle, pi over 4 times 28 squared. Okay? So, this is in mm square. So, ilan yung sagot natin? Yeah, so our area, ang AS natin is 2463. Again, you can actually check this one using your calculators. While ang compression area natin, sinabi dito na dalawa lang na 28 mm bar. So, lagyan natin dito, dalawa. Yan. AS prime to, ha? Be very careful sa mga variables natin. Yan. AS prime yung compression, AS yung tension. Okay? So, next, ano pa yung given natin? FC prime, meron tayong FC prime. So, meron tayong FC prime na 20.7. Meron tayong FY na 415. And concrete cover to centroid of the reinforcement 70. So, gawin ko na lang itong D prime, which is 70. Again, 70 yan, ha? Balik tayo sa figure last time. Yan, o. So, ito yun, ha? Ang concrete cover to centroid of the reinforcement is ito yan. Ito, dalawa kasi yung concrete cover natin, yung sa baba at saka yung nasa itaas. Anyway, since equal man lang sila, I will just name both of them as D prime. Okay? Ay, lalagay ko na lang yung isa na cover. Center cover equal 70 mm din. Ganyan, para hindi tayo malito kung ano yung D prime at saka ano yung cover. So, meron tayong last, raw balance. Raw balance is 0.021. If ever makalimut, if ever mawala, pag-solve ninyo sa, if ever pag-solve ninyo sa board exam, hindi lumabas yung tamang sagot ba, try to assume a raw balance of 0.021. Usually, ito yung ginagamit ng examiner. Again, that is because minsan nakakalimutan yung mga given. Okay? But anyway, hindi naman siya, if ever lang, hindi lalabas yung sagot. But usually, lalabas man yan. The exams are actually, this subject ba, yung mga choices and the exam is very, prepared meticulously ng examiner natin. So I think okay na tayo dito. So question number one, calculate the depth of the rectangular stress block. Okay? Anyway, for simplification, assume both tension and compression steel yield. So ito yung maganda sa board exam. Alam na examiner no, medyo mataas yung solution natin. Usually, binibigyan na tayo ng mga shortcut ba? Okay? We can actually skip some of the steps. Okay, because of the assumptions. For example, oh, yung raw balance, binigay na agad instead of we can actually solve this one. Yung ito, we actually need to check no, if the steel yields or hindi. Anyway, sinabi na niya, so we don't need to check. And then neglect concrete area displaced by steel. Anong ibig sabihin nito? Neglect, baka magtaka kayo ba? Neglect concrete area displaced by steel. Balik tayo. Andito pala. Now, sa beam natin, ah, diba? Diba ito yung parang A, sabihin natin this is A and then this is B, rebar and then rebar din diyan. Now ang area, di ba? Ang area dito is A times B, di ba? Area diyan A times B, di ba? Ang concrete strength natin is 0.85 FC prime multiplied by A times B. However, that is actually not the correct area. Bakit? Kasi actually meron tayong nabawas na area ng concrete. So, yung A times B dapat, we need to subtract this one with the area of our AS prime. However, for simplification purposes, usually, no, for practical purposes, we actually just neglect this one. Okay? So, i-neglect mo na lang yan para same pa din yung value ng C1 mo. Okay? Para hindi kayo malito. Dito ba sa C1? Para yung value ng C1 mo, hindi magbabago. 0.85 FC prime AB pa din. So, baka magtaka kayo ba? Ano kaya ibig sabihin nito? Baka malito na kayo. Anyway, let's try to solve. So, is this analysis or design? I think it's fairly obvious, no? This is actually analysis. We are given with the dimension and the rebar. Hello? Nandiyan pa kayo? Hello? Ah, sige. So, let's check natin kung paano natin i-analyze ulit. So, the first thing to do is to check the raw maximum, no? Check natin yung raw maximum. So, raw max natin, let's assume no, na ang raw max natin is 0.75 sa raw balance. Again, this is not true ha. Ang raw max natin, alam natin yung value ng raw max talaga. However, yan lang yung ginamit natin. This is because given kasi yung raw balance. But sa inyo, alam niyo na kung equation. So, that's 0.0158. Ay, sorry. 0.0158. By the way, try to interrupt me sa discussion if yung nakikita nyo sa screen is hindi yung sinasabi ko, baka kasi hindi ko na switch yung slides. Okay? So anyway, meron tayong raw max. Now let's try to solve down our actual raw. Yung raw natin, i-solve down natin yung raw natin. So our raw is actually equal to AS, diba? AS over BD. So ano yung raw natin? Uy, ano yung D natin? Ah, wala pala tayong D. So, effective depth, let's try to declare our effective depth first. So, effective depth is actually the total height of the beam minus, di ba? Minus yung clear cover natin or clear cover, centroidal cover natin. Yeah. So, our effective depth is 330 mm. So, meaning our rho is actually 0.0213. Therefore, tingnan nyo, ang rho is greater than rho max. Hindi pwede. So, which is why, di ba? Which is why we need to analyze this one as doubly reinforced beam. I hope okay tayo dyan. So, next step, sana yan? Yeah. Next step is to compute for the depth of neutral axis. Although, ang tinanong sa problem, ano ba yung tinanong sa problem? Ang tinanong sa problem is the depth of rectangular stress block, yung A, no? So, tayo, we just need to compute for the C na lang muna. Anyway, we can easily solve A once we have the value of C. So, to compute for the rectangular stress block, again, you need to assume, no, na nag-yield muna ang tension steel. I mean, ang compression. Ay, actually, sinabi na sa problem. So, we do not need to assume. Diretso na agad. So, if ever, nakalimutan nyo yung equation na yan, yung ASFY, again, just remember the concept. Okay, sa doubly reinforced ba? I-remember nyo lang yung concept sa doubly reinforced, which is ito. Yan. Total T is equal to C1 plus C2. Ganun lang talaga. Total T is equal to C1 plus C2. Okay, so let's try to solve. T is equal to C1 plus C2. Ano nga ulit? Ay, sorry. Yan. Ano nga ulit yung T natin? AS. Diba? AS times FY. Sir, bakit FY? Sinabi sa problem na nag-yield. Okay? Yan, dito. Ay, sorry. AS FY. So, this must be equal to C1, again, I'm talking about the concrete, di ba? C1, oh, yung concrete natin. Okay, so C1, that's 0.85. Epsilon prime. A is unknown. However, I do not want A. I actually, pwede tayong diretso na sa A kasi we do not need to solve for C kasi alam natin na nag-yield na. Diretso tayo sa A. A times B. Ano yung B natin? 350. Now, plus C2. Ano yung C2? This is the force sa compression bar. Again, C2 is AS prime, FS prime. In this case, since nag-yield man, we do not need to use FS prime. AS prime, FY agad. Okay, plus AS prime, FY agad. Okay, so notice that the only unknown in your, ang only unknown sa problem na to is yung A. Try to solve daw yung A. Please use your calculator and then try to solve for A. Ano yung makukuha ninyo? Paki-check daw. If same ba tayo na makukuha? Ang A ko dito is 83. I-solve nyo daw. Again ha, you can, sa calculator, you can easily solve this one using your calculator ha. Hindi nyo gagawin to ha sa board exam. Walang kayong matkan sa board exam. So, sa calculator, bali, ilagay nyo lang agad AS. Ilagay nyo yung value ng AS natin, which is 2463. Paki-solve daw. Check if same ba tayo.
Enter.
Same lang. Okay, sige. Salamat, salamat. So, ilalagay ko lang agad na ang A is actually equal to 83 mm. So, since nakuha na natin, we do not need to check if steel yields or steel does not yield. Automatic, this will be our answer. Yan. Okay, for number 1. Okay, so solve natin yung number 2. So, sa question number 2, determine that the design bending strength mu, capacity reduction factor is 0.9. Okay, so again, ito yung maganda sa board exam. Meron tayong mga steps that we can actually skip due to the hints, nor not necessarily hint, but the assumption of the examiner. Now, these assumptions are important para same tayo ng, same tayo ng mga sagot ba? This is because pag nag-design kasi tayo or pag nag-investigate, there are a lot of, may mga chances mga dalawa yung unknown and then we need to have a trial and error and then baka iba yung assumption natin. So, anyway, ano yung hinahanap? We want to solve for mu. I think madali na lang, no? Mu, ano nga ulit yung mu natin? Mu basically is just equal to phi mn. Yan, phi times mn. Okay. Again, ano yung mn natin? Mn is actually equal to, total mn natin is mn1, no? Mn1 plus mn2. Ay, sorry. Yan. Again, MN1 natin. Check natin. Ano yung MN1 natin? Balik na tayo dito sa PDF natin. Yan. So, ang MN1 natin, that is actually equal to, you know, 0.85 FC prime AB D minus A over 2. While MN2 is AS prime FS prime D minus A over 2. Okay? So, napakadali na. However, instead of using 0.85, di ba this is actually C1? Instead of using this one, actually, ito na lang kasi wala tayong AS1 pala, no? Sige, yan na lang. So, mu actually equal to phi is 0.9 multiplied by mn1, that is, ano nga ulit yung mn1 natin? Ay, sorry, hindi nyo nangit kaya. mn1 is 0.85 times fc prime times a, nakuha na natin ang a, times b, and ang moment arm is d minus a over 2. Again, this is very important, ha, yung moment arm. Huwag niyong ipagpalit yung moment, ipalit ba yung moment arm. And then plus, yan. MN2, again, ang MN2 is the moment, nominal moment caused by the, yung rebar natin, yung pangalawang step ba, ito ba? Yan, ito. So, the moment caused by here, you can either sum up moment yung C2, okay? You can either C2 mag-rotate dito or yung AS2, mag-rotate dito. It's up to you kung ano yung gagamitin mo. However, take note, if ito yung ito ba? If AS2 FY times D minus D prime, you will have a problem kasi wala kang AS2. Diba? Wala tayong AS2, wala din tayong AS1. Meron tayong total AS. Which is why kanina, yung M1 ko, ang MN1 ko is, itong C1 ang pinaikot ko. Which is 0.85 FC prime, diba? Ito yung ginamit ko. 0.85 fc prime d minus a over 2. Kasi wala kasi akong as1. The same din dito. Since wala akong as2, then ito yung ipapaikot ko yan dyan. And then yung c2 yung nakikita ko sa equation. So c2 is actually as prime times fs prime, or in this case fy, multiplied by d minus d prime. Again ha, wag nyong, sorry. Again, do not interchange, ha? Wag nyong interchange yung moment arm. Ang moment arm for the first moment, MN1, is d minus a over 2. The second moment arm is d minus d prime. So you will have your mu. Uy, sorry. Wala pa na dyan. Uy, wala akong d. Ah, okay. Sorry. Yan pala. Oops. So, gusto natin, ang unit natin is kilonewton meter. Check nyo daw if same ba tayo ng sagot. 252.2941.
Same na, sir.
Sige, sige. So, let's proceed sa number. Lagyan mo natin yung mu dito. Uy, sorry. Okay. So, let's proceed sa number 3. Ito tayo sa number 3. Now, sa number 3, ito yung medyo hindi na talaga to RC. Well, parang theory na ang tanong na to. By the way, do not expect no na per situation, ang problem per situation is, for example, itong problem na to RC lang. No. Actually, sa board exam, one situation, pwedeng magamit niyo ang statics or theory, mechanics, at saka steel sa isang tanungan lang, okay? There are actually cases that you can use all the previous subjects ba, mga prerequisite subjects. In this case, we will use our theory, no? Na, dadun, theory na loadings, topic natin sa loadings. So, if the beam daw, we reinforce such that the nominal bending strength at factored loads is 400, what is the safe concentrated live load at mid-span that the beam, in addition to a total dead load at 20 kilonewton per meter, can carry? Again, tingnan natin ha. The beam daw, if the beam we reinforce such that the nominal bending strength, nominal ha, take note, hindi ultimate nominal. Nominal is 400 kilonewton. So actually, wala nang silbi yung ito. Wala nang silbi itong sinolve natin dito. Ito ba? Hindi na natin magagamit yan kasi binigyan na tayo ng bagong design moment. In this case, a new MN daw natin. Ano ba yung MN natin dito? Sinabi, that's 400, no? 400 kilonewton meter. So, 400. Sorry. Kilonewton meter. Okay? Ay, sorry. Yan, 400 kilonewton meter. And then, we want to solve for, ano yung hinahanap natin? What is the safe concentrated live load at mid-span? Ah, okay. So, hinahanap natin ang concentrated live load sa mid-span. Okay? So, actually, ang gagawin natin, we just need to equate the ultimate moment sa maximum moment sa beam. So, our ultimate moment is actually Mn over phi, di ba? I mean, Mn over Mn times phi. Mu is actually equal to phi Mn. So, ang phi natin, lagyan na lang natin agad, 0.9 times itong Mn natin. Yan. So, ito yung ultimate moment natin. Yan. Now, this moment must be equal to the actual moment sa beam natin. Now, our beam, sinabi sa problem, no, we have a beam daw na nagkakari ng, we have a simply supported beam with a span of 5 meters. Meron siyang dead load. So, ang dead load natin is 20 kilonewton per meter, while live load is, sana yan, safe live load natin is yung tinanong. Okay? So, balik tayo. So, ang dead load natin is 20 kilonewton per meter, while ang live load natin nasa gitna is actually, yun yung hinahanap sa problem. Okay, again, sinabi ko na to last time, di ba? For these types of loading, do not bother deriving the actual moment. Rather, no, you need to memorize certain equations. Okay, so again, for the maximum moment, di ba? Ang maximum moment sa mid-span, that's PL over 4 because of this concentrated load from your theory. Di ba? That's PL over 4. While the maximum moment, because of this uniformly distributed load, is WL squared over 8. Okay, now just don't forget the factor, di ba? Since this is dead load, so ang factor nito is 1.2. Ang factor sa live load is 1.2. 6. Okay, so diretso tayo. Check natin sa solution. Yan. Yan, so MU is actually equal to, ano yun? 1.6. I'm sorry. 1.2. Dead load is actually given, no? That's, ano ba yung dead load natin? Ilagay lang natin agad 20 times. Again natin dito 3 to. Ano yun? 20 kN per meter. Yan. So, dead load, W L squared. We already have our L, no? Na-declare na natin ang variable L of L squared over 8. And then, plus 1.6 times PL cubed. In this case, yung P yung hinaharap natin. B times PL over 4 pala na PL cubed. Yeah. So, the only unknown is actually yung P. Anyway, try to solve daw ang P kung ano yung masosolve natin sa P. Check natin if same ba yung makukuha natin dito. Please use your calculator and then check. Ay, ganun. Kaya pala kilonewton. This is kilonewton per meter. Yan pala. So, our P is actually 142.5 using your calculator. Please use your calculator, ha? Pag nag-solve kayo. Okay, so double check na natin using our calculator. So, again, MU is 360. That must be equal to 1.2 dead load. 20 times 5 squared, no? 5 squared WL squared over 8 plus 1.6 PL over 4. Ano yung P natin? Unknown. Again, ilagay nyo dito X, no? Pag-anan, PL is 5 over 4. Shift solve. Always magbigay kayo ng malapit na answer ba? Anyway, pwedeng 0 na lang. So you have 142.5. Okay lang, do you have any questions before we can move on sa next problem? Naintindihan lang? Hello?
Kera, sir.
Okay ra. Okay, sige, move on tayo. So, next problem, yan o.